1. First we'll define it and we'll understand what is Playfair Cipher. So what is Playfair Cipher? Playfair Cipher is best known multiple letter encryption cipher, which treats diagrams in the plain text as single units and translates these units into ciphertext diagrams. Confusing? Well, the definition is, but not the Playfair Cipher. So when we'll take a look at the example, you'll understand it much more better. Step 2. What are the requirements? So we'll see what are the requirements for the Playfair cipher. The Playfair cipher is based on the use of 5x5 matrix of letters constructed using the keyword. Okay. Here we will take a look at the example with the keyword monarchy. So suppose this is our keyword, it's monarchy. So we first draw a 5x5 matrix over here. That is, we draw 5 columns and 5 rows, and then we write the keyword from the starting. So what is our keyword? Monarchy. So we start monarchy. Okay, so we have written our keyword. Now you got to understand that this is a 5x5 matrix, so the total number of boxes that we have are 25, and we have total 26 number of letters. So what we do is, when we are writing I and J, we write them in one box only. We don't write both of them in separate boxes, we just write in one box only. Some people just skip the J, but I'm telling you to keep the J. Okay, just put the I and J in the same box. Okay, so since we have written our monarchy keyword over here, now how to fill the rest of the boxes in the 5x5 matrix? Well, it's very simple, guys. We start from the ABC order till Z, and then we check out if that letter is already existent in the keyword. If it is, then we don't write it over here. So that's what we want. We don't want to repeat the letters. So since in our keyword over here we already have A, okay, so we don't write A over here. Instead, we just go for the next letter, that is B. Now again, next letter is C, but C letter is already there in the keyword monarchy, so we don't write C, we go for D. After D we have E, after E we have F, then we have G, then we have H, but H is also there in the keyword, so we don't write it, we just go for I and J in the same box. Okay, then we go for K, then we go for L, then M comes, and M is already existent in our keyword, so we don't write it again. We go for N, N is also again there in our keyword, so we don't write N also. And then comes O, O is also there in our keyword. Then comes P, we write P. Then Q, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y is there in our keyword, so we don't write it, and then we write Z. So this is how we construct our 5x5 matrix, guys, for our Playfair cipher. We'll go for the step 3 now. Step 3, we'll understand what are the rules, guys. What are the rules for encrypting and decrypting the Playfair text or simple text into our encrypted text? So these are the rules. First rule, plain text is encrypted 2 letters at a time. Repeating plain text letters that are in the same pair are separated with a filler letter such as X. So we'll take a look at an example over here. Suppose we have a simple plain text like this, balloon. Okay, so how we treat this is, first rule is what? We group it 2 letters, this in groups. So BA, but LL are in the same pair and they are repeating. So what we do is, instead of writing LL, we add a filler letter called X, or any letter we can use, X, and then we separate it, and then the next L goes with the O and the next O goes with the N. So this is how we group it in groups of 2, and we separate it with a filler letter. So that is rule number 1. Now rule number 2, 2 plain text letters that fall in the same row of matrix are each replaced by the letter to the right, with the first element to the row circularly following the last. Now what does this mean is, suppose we have written our keyword in the 5x5 matrix and we have completed writing down all other letters and made the 5x5 matrix ready. Now if you want to encrypt the letter and the group of 2 letters, they fall in the same row in that 5x5 matrix. So how we replace it, or how we encrypt it? We encrypt each letter with the letter that is immediately to the right of it, and it follows in the circular fashion. That is, the after the last letter we go for the first letter. So you might get confused with what I'm trying to say right now, but when we take a look at an example, you'll understand it better. Just hang in there. Now rule number 3, 2 plain text letters that fall in the same column are each replaced with the letter below it. Now similarly, we had over here in the same row, so we replaced it with the letter to the right. Over here, if those two letters are in the same column, we replace it with the letter below it, and then again it also follows in the circular fashion. And the last rule, if otherwise each plain text letter in a pair is replaced by the letter that lies in its own row and column occupied by the other plain text letter. Suppose they are in not in same row nor in same column, but they are in different rows and different columns. What do we do is we replace it with the letter that lies in its own row but in the column where the other letter lies. So when we take a look at the example, you will understand all these four rules very easily. Now let's take a look at the step number four. Step four, so we'll solve an example and you'll understand it completely, guys. So don't worry, it's very easy. Now let's take a keyword monarchy. As we had seen, we'll take the keyword, same keyword monarchy, for our example, and this is how the table will look. I had already drawn it, but I'm still again drawing it for you guys so that you understand and you can refer it easily. So we write the keyword monarchy, then we fill it with the other letters, b because a is already there, d because c is already there, e, f, g, h, h is already there, so we don't write h, we go for I, j, then k, l, m and n are already there in our keyword over here, so we go, and also o, so we go for p, q, r. R is also existent in our keyword, so we don't write it. Then s, t, u, v, w, x, n, y is there in our keyword, and then z. So this is how we write our 5x5 matrix. So we have done with our first step of making the 5x5 matrix. Now then let's encrypt the sentence. Let's take this sentence, hello sir. Okay, so what we do is we separate this statement in the group of two letters. Okay, step one, so it will look like this, he. Now we are in this hello, this 2l are coming in the same pair and they are repeating letters, so what we do, we add the filler letter and it becomes helx, then lo, then si, and then now since this is also one important rule, guys, suppose if it is odd number of letters in your statement, what happens is the last letter might be the one which is just a single, it doesn't have a pair, so what we do, we again add a filler letter to it at the end of it. Okay, so remember this exercise. Now that's what I have said over here, why we add x in between, because according to our rules, if two letters are repeating, we have to add the buffer letter in between, buffer letter or filler letter, whatever letter you want to call it. Also if the pairs are not complete, then at the end we might need to add the letter x over here. Okay, so this is how we do it and this is how we write it in the pair of two, h e l x l o s I r x. So this is step number one. Now let's take a look at step number two. Now refer the table for each pair of letters. First pair is h e. Okay, this is h e. Now letters h and e don't lie in the same row nor in the same column. We can take a look at it in the table. See, this is our letter h, this is our letter, where is EE, over here. They don't lie in the same row, no, they don't lie in the same column. Okay, so what we do is we replace each letter that is there in its own row, okay, in its own row but in the corresponding column to the letter the second letter. So what we do, H will be replaced by C because it's in its own row and it is in the column where E is there, so we replace it with C, and E will be replaced with F because it's in the same row as E and it's in the column of H, so it will be replaced with C and F. We can see over here, so H and E don't lie in the same row nor the same column, so we use the rule number 4. We have our rule number 4 over here. If each plain text letter doesn't lie in the same row nor same column, then we replace it with the letter that lies in its own row and the column occupied by the other plain text letter. So this is rule number 4 that we have applied over here. You can see, so we use rule number 4 and replace it with C and F. C over here, H, it has a letter in its own row and it is in the column of E, so C, and for E we have a letter in its own row and that lies in the column of H, so that is F. Okay, now let's take a look at the next pair, second pair, that is LX. letters L and X also don't lie in the same row, nor they do lie in the same column. So what we use, we again use the rule number 4 and replace it LX with SU. Why SU? Let's take a look at it. It was LX, guys. So where is our L? L is over here. And where is our X? X is over here. Okay. So what we do is, we replace a letter L with a letter that lies in its own row with the letter that lies in its own, in the second letter's column. So it is S. Okay. It lies in L's row and in the column of X. So it is S. And then we replace X with a letter that lies in its own row and in the column of L. So it will be U. Okay. So it will be X, S and U. Okay. So that is how we get the SU. Third pair, L and O. Letters L and O also don't lie in the same row nor in the same column. So we again use rule number 4 and replace LO with PM. Now let's see why PM. So it is LO. Okay. Now this is our L over here and we have O over here. Okay. So we replace L with the letter that is there in its own row and the column of O. So it comes to P. Okay. And we replace O with the letter that is there in its own row and in the column of L. So it will be M. So it will be replaced with P and M. Okay. LO is replaced with PM. And then the fourth pair is SI. Okay. Now letter S and I lie in the same column. Let's take a look at it. Okay. Where is it? S and I. They lie in the same column. So what we do is we take a look at our rules. Okay. Two plaintext letters that fall in the same row of matrix. Wait, is it same row? No, it's same column. Okay, so two plaintext letters, rule number 3. Two plaintext letters that fall in the same column are each replaced with the letter below it, with the above element of that column circularly following the last element. Let's take a look. S will be replaced with X. I will be replaced with S because it is the next letter that is below it. So that's how we replace it. So what do we get instead of SI? We get XS. Let's see. Yeah, SI will be replaced with XS. That is our fourth pair. Now we are done with the fourth pair. Now we'll take a look at the last pair. Okay, last pair is fifth pair. Letter R and X don't lie in the same row nor in the same column. So we use the rule number 4 and replace RX with AZ. Okay. So AZ, where is it? RX. So PQ, no, over here, R and X, they don't lie in the same row nor in the same column. So what do we get? R will be replaced with letter in its own row in the column of X. So it will be A, and X will be replaced with a letter in its own row with the letter in the column of R. So it will be Z. So it is A and Z. So let's see. Yeah, RX will be replaced with AZ. So this is what we will get after the encryption. Okay, this is our plain text hello sir, and after encryption we'll get C. Let's see. HA will be replaced with CF. Okay, so that's what we read, CF. Then LX will be replaced with SU. Okay, so we write SU. Then LO will be replaced with PM. Okay, then we write PM over here. Then SI will be replaced with XS. So we write XS. Then RX will be replaced with AZ. So that's it. So this is our encrypted text. Now you can neglect the spaces, guys. Spaces are not that important. Okay. The decryption can be done in the same way, guys. Just follow the same rules and then again try to decrypt this encrypted text with the following rules with the same 5x5 matrix. You'll get back your original hello sir. Let's see how to do it. Now using the table and the following rules, you can do the decryption. After decryption, you will get back the message as HELXLOSIRX. Now you remove the X and then you will get hello sir. As you can see, you just have to add that space, but it is understandable that it is hello sir because there are two letters in which we have put the X. So you can understand that this is a filler letter, as well as this is the end letter, and the filler letters can be understood because they are something that make the text encryptable. So if you remove that X, you'll get hello sir back, and That's it for today, guys. We have understood how to encrypt the text, how to decrypt the text using Playfair Cipher. If you have any doubts, any questions, or anything you want me to add or explain in a much more better way, please ask them in the comment section below. I'll be really happy to help you guys with this thing. Now, if you like this video, guys, please hit that like button. Please subscribe to the channel and ask me if you have any doubts in the comment section below. Please share this video with your friends, guys, if you think they need to understand how to do it. And feel free to ask anything in the comment section below. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one.